Hello all, welcome back to the class, and today's discussion is about structures in C. So before getting into what is a structure, first we should know when we are going for this concept called structure, okay, or why we are using this concept structure. And when we want to store any data item, okay, a single data item, then we can make use of primitive data variables like int, num, then float type variable, and then character type variable. Like, we can use any primitive data type variable in order to store a data item, that is a single data item. And if there is a need to store collection of data items, then at that time we can go for an array, right? So array is used to hold group of data items, and that too those data items should be of same data type. There are some cases where we need to store collection of data items, but those data items are of different data types. In that case, we can go for this concept called structure. So structure means it is a collection of variables of different data types that can be represented by a single name. So with the help of structure, we can store collection of data items which is of different data types. That is what the basic difference between array and structure. So array is used to hold group of items of same data type, whereas structure is used to hold group of data items but of different data types, right? And here the structure is also represented by a single name. And this structure is actually a user defined data type, okay, which is also called as a derived data type. So here the structure comes under the category derived data type. For example, when we can go for the structure is when we need to store the bank customer details. Okay, so if we take bank customer details, those details involves customer name, then customer date of birth, account number, then a branch name, then the balance amount that is there in their account. Okay, so all these things comes under customer details. And if you see customer name, it is a string type of data. And coming to customer date of birth, so here also it is an integer type of data. The same for account number. And coming for branch, it is of again string type. And for balance, it should be in a floating type value, right? So here in this bank customer details, we have collection of datas, and though all those datas are of different data types. So when we need to store these kinds of datas, okay, at that time we can go for the structure concept, okay? So now we will see how to define the structure. Okay, defining a structure. This is the syntax which we use to define a structure. And here struct, okay, it is a keyword. Here struct is a keyword. The struct tag name, okay, here tag name is the name of the structure. We can give any name here, and that should be the name of our structure. And this struct is a keyword which is used to create a structure. So here is the definition of structure. Within this curly braces, we can have variable declarations. Okay, so data type variable 1, data type variable 2. And these variables can be of different data types. It is not necessary that all these variables should be of a single data type. Okay, so we can use different data types inside this. Right? And we have to end this structure with semicolon. Okay, and here we are using semicolon after this curly braces. So this is what the syntax for defining a structure. And these variables inside this structure are called as members of structure. Okay, so these are all called as members of structure, or we can say these are all member variables, right? So here these are all the members of this structure with the tag name. Okay, so here tag name represents the structure name. This is an example for structure. Here again we are using the keyword struct, and for tag name we have used person. Now this person is the name of our structure, and inside this structure we have data types, that is variables with different data types. The first variable is name, which is of character data type, and the second variable is course, which is of character data type again. And the next variable is age, which is of integer data type. Okay, so here we have different variables with different data types. and you can see the curly braces. There is open curly brace and closed curly brace that is ending with a semicolon. Okay, and these variables are called as member variables, right? So this is how we can define a structure. Then how we can declare the structure variable. Okay, so here structure variable means we have a variable for the structure person. Okay, as I mentioned here, these variables are called as member variables, and we can create one more variable which is a structure variable. There is a difference between member variable and structure variable. Now we will see the syntax to declare a structure variable. So this is the syntax we can use to declare the structure variable, that is starting with the keyword struct and then tag name. So here tag name represents the name of the structure, and then we can have variable list, that is we can give variable names here, and it is not necessary that we can give only one variable name here. Okay, so which means here we can give list of variables. Here we can declare list of variables for a structure. So this is what the syntax to declare a structure variable, and this is the example for declaring a structure variable for this structure, right, with the keyword struct, and here the name of the structure is person. So here we are using the name of the structure person, and this p is actually the variable name. Okay, so this is the structure variable, and why we are going for this structure variable. So the purpose of structure variable is to access the member variable. When you want to access the member variables of a structure, we cannot directly access these member variables of structure. So in order to access it, we need a structure variable. With the help of this structure variable only, we can access the member variables of a structure. That is why we are going for this structure variable declaration, right? There are a number of ways to declare the structure variable, and this is one way. Now let us see the second way how we can declare the structure variable. The second way is by using typedef. Okay, so when you are using typedef, this is how you can declare a structure and a structure variable. So before writing the structure, before the keyword struct, we are using the typedef, right? So typedef, struct, then structure name. And inside we have members, right? Member variables. And after this, instead of writing the struct keyword once again, when you use typedef, there is no necessity to write the struct keyword again for declaring a structure variable. Okay, so without writing the struct keyword directly with the structure name followed by variable list. Okay, we can declare structure variables like this when you use typedef. If you don't use typedef, then we have to give struct person PQS. If you are using typedef, then it is not necessary to give struct keyword here for declaring the structure variables, right? So this is the second way to declare a structure variable. Then the third way to declare structure variable is this one. So while writing the structure itself, so before this semicolon, we can give the variable list here. Okay, directly we can write the variables here. We can give variable names here before this semicolon. So if you have given like this, then there is no need to write struct person and then variable names. So directly you can give like this. You can declare a structure variable like this. So struct, structure name, and inside this curly braces we have member variables, and outside this curly braces we are declaring structure variables, and after that we are using this semicolon. Okay, this is the third way for declaring a structure variable. And coming to the next important point in our structure is this dot notation. Okay, what is this dot notation, or why we are going for this dot notation is, as I specified, when you want to access the members of your structure, then we have to access it with the help of variable, right? Structure variable. Then how we can access this members, okay, how we can access these member variables is by the help of this dot notation. So with the help of this dot notation, we can able to access the members of these structures. So how we can access it? The example is given here. So I'm taking the same example. If you look at here, we have a variable called p. So when I want to access the name, okay, then how I can access this name is like p dot name. Okay, so p dot, here is the use of your dot notation. So p is the structure variable and name is the member variable. So by using this dot notation, we are going to access this member variable with the structure variable. So p dot name is equal to rom. So now I have assigned a name for this variable, member variable, and the next line is p dot age is equal to 21. So I have assigned the age for this variable age, right? In the same way, you can give q dot name, then q dot age, right? So we can use this dot notation in this way in order to access the member variables. This is all about the declaration and definition of structure. And the next one is initialization of structure. How we can initialize the members? Okay, so how we can initialize the members of a structure? So as like in the previous method, like when you are having a primitive variable, then we can initialize the primitive variable with the declaration statement itself. Also in arrays also, when you want to initialize an array variable, we can do it with declaration itself. But in structure, we cannot initialize the members of structures with declaration. For example, if you take the structure struct percent, so inside we have a member variable name, which is assigned with a value rom, and the other variable age assigned with the value 21, right? So we cannot initialize the variables like this. Okay, these are all the declarations. Okay, here we are declaring the name and here we are declaring the age. So with the declaration, we cannot initialize the members here, which is a compilation error, which will throw a compilation error. Okay, so this is not possible for structure. So if we can't initialize it with the declaration, then how can we initialize the members of a structure? So that can be done with the structure variable. Okay, so this is where the structure variable is taking place. So here we are using structure variable for initializing the member variables. Okay, and when you are initializing the member variables with structure variable, how you should initialize it means the element should be listed inside pair of braces. Okay, whatever the datas, whatever the values we are giving for the members of a structure, those elements should be listed inside pair of braces and they should be separated by a comma. Okay, so we'll see the example, and this is the example. Here we have a struct which a person is the name of the structure, and inside that structure we have variable name, there is member variable name and member variable age. So now we want to initialize this name and age. So how we can initialize this? By this, that is, we have to create, that is, we have to declare a variable first. So here I'm declaring a variable struct percent p, and for this variable p I'm just assigning the values, and if you look at here, the values are assigned inside the curly braces. Okay, also the variables are given, that is, they are separated, the values are separated by comma. Okay, the first value is rom and the second value is 21. So now I'm assigning the value rom to the name and the value 21 to the age. Okay, so this is how I'm doing initialization, right? And here when you're doing this initialization part, you have to take care of two things here. One is order and type of values. Okay, so here this is the order, and the type of values you're giving here should match with the member variable. Okay, so what is the first member variable that you are declaring here, which is a name, and that is of type character? And what is the second member variable you are declaring? Age, which is of type int. So when you are giving values, when you are initializing it, the order and the type, the data type, should match with these order and data type. So first I have given RAM, which is of type string. So this is actually a string, right? Even though we are using character data type, here we are using array, one dimensional array of character, so which is a string. And here I have given string type of data. So this first data will be assigned to this first variable. And coming to the second value, which is 21, which is of integer type. And here we have age, which is of integer type again. So the second value will be assigned to this age. So in this way, when you're initializing the structure, there is a members of a structure, you have to note the order. You should be careful in the order and the type of values that you're giving. Okay, so these values should match with the member variable. The type and the order should match with the member variable. And the second point you have to note here is the default value of member variables are for integer type of data, the default value is 0. And for floating type of data, the default value is 0.0. And for character type of data, the default value assigned will be a null character, that is slash 0. So this slash 0 represents the null character. If you are not initializing anything to this variables, okay, if you are not initializing these variables, then by default, these variables will be initialized with some values. If it is integer type of data, the value 0 will be assigned, initialized. And if it is string type of data or character type of data, then null character will be assigned here. If it is a float type, then 0.0 will be assigned here, right? We also have another type of initialization here, that is designated initialization. Hope you remember this designated initialization in array. We have discussed in array about this designated initialization. So in the same way, we are using this designated initialization in structure concept also. So why we are going for this designated initialization? Because here, when you want the members to be initialized in any order, then we can go for this designated initialization. So I already mentioned, when you are initializing, then you have to take care of the order and the type of data that you are giving, right? And if you don't want to take care of any order, okay, if you want to give data to any items without considering the order or without focusing on the order, then we can go for this designated initialization. So here the members are getting initialized in any order. So how we can do this type of initialization? Okay, how this can be done? And here is the example for that. If you look at here, we have a struct and the structure is person. And inside this, again, we have the same variables name and age of character type and integer type. And here we have the variable, okay, structure variable. And in this structure variable, if you see here, I'm using the variable name, that is a member variable name along with the date dot operator. So with this, I'm assigning the value to this particular variable, right? In the previous example, we didn't use any name, okay, any variable name we didn't use here. Directly we are giving the values, and that values will be assigned to that particular variable directly. But in this initialization, what we are doing, we are specifying the variable name along with the dot notation, okay, and then we are assigning the value to that particular variable. So here, if you look at the order, first I have initialized the variable age, and then the second part I'm initializing the name, right? So here we are not considering any order, okay? So the order is not followed here, right? So this is why we are going for this designated initialization, or this is how we can use the designated initialization. And we'll see one example so that we'll understand about the concept structure. So this is the example, and starting with the header file followed by a main function, and inside main function, the first statement is a declaration statement. So we are declaring something here. After this, we are declaring a structure. We are defining a structure. So the keyword struct is used, followed by the name of the structure. Here the name of the structure is book. And inside this structure, we have some variables, okay, members. These are all the member variables. And the first member variable is title, which is of character type. The second variable is page of integer type. And the third variable is price of float type. Okay, now in the next statement, I'm declaring a structure variable. Here the structure variable is B. So with the structure variable, I'm going to initialize. Okay, and what I'm initializing here, I'm just initializing only one value. And what is this value? this value is the first value. And what is the first variable? We have title, right? So for this title, this value C programming will be assigned. Okay, after this, we are not assigning anything to these variables. So what happens here? By default, the integer type of data will be having, that is, will be initialized to 0. And the floating type of variable will be initialized with 0.0 by default, right? Because here we have initialized only the variable title, but we didn't initialize these variables, right? So when we try to print all these all the values of these variables, then what will be printed as output? So let us see that in the printf statement, I'm trying to print the title name, okay, that is percentage yes, because it is a string. So I'm mentioning the format specifier percentage yes slash t for giving tab space, then percentage d for page number because it is of integer type. So percentage d slash t for tab space, then for float I'm using percentage f and slash n is for next line. And if you see here, how am I accessing these variables? I cannot directly give title, page and price here. Okay, when you want to access the members of a structure, we should access it with the help of the structure variable along with the dot notation, right? So that is why I'm using b dot title, then b dot page and then b dot price. So when we are given with this printf statement, what will be printed as output? First, b dot title will be assigned with C programming. So it will print C programming. And coming to b dot page, so we didn't initialize anything to this page. So what happens? By default, the value 0 will be assigned, right? So it will print 0 here. And for floating price, it will print 0.000000, right? So this is how the structure works.